Drew's on his way to a museum in the seaside town of Western-Super-Mare, where his passion will certainly be stirred up, as he has a personal as well as a professional interest in the contents.
We are going to see Stuart Lanning, and he owns the Lambretta Museum. He is starting to sell off the collection, basically buying it from a museum. Hopefully, we're going to get either a real rarity or something nice and unrestored.
The Lambretta Museum has been run for over 10 years by die-hard scooter fan Stuart Lanning. He's now closing it in preparation for his retirement, and everything, bikes included, is up for grabs.
We've got a whole range of scooters, starting with the A model all the way through to the Indian Polo. There are a few special models in here. Behind me, there's the Olympic scooter. We've got the rickshaw. I've got other stuff he may be interested in, memorabilia that he can look at, so we'll just see how it goes.
Drew is passionate about anything with an engine that has two or four wheels, so the chance to visit a scooter museum that's closing down is a rare and tempting opportunity.
Are we doing business-related things today, or
yeah,
Drew?
Well, no. Everything is... Every purchase is a potential profit.
The Lambretta Museum could be really good for business if he comes back with posters or signage, anything to do with sort of scooter memorabilia. My only concern is that Drew is scooter mad and his buying won't just stop with his business head.
Go. I love it. I want one.
But of course, there's little that gets between man and machine. Drew's been tempted straight onto the beach with tea to experience the museum's collection hands-on.
Three! That was fun.
That was fun.
These are great. This is fantastic. Love this. Just love the lightness of it.
Yeah.
It's super.
Fired up by his ride, Drew heads into the museum to find out what's up for grabs.
Wow. Oh, my God. Right, you're going to have to educate me now. I am a scooterist, but I'm Vespa.
Is he allowed to say the V word in here? Come on, swearing like that.
I know.
So, give us a potted history. History of Lambretta, please.
The first Lambrettas were built was this one here. It's called the A model.
What year is that, 47?
1947 A model. Innocenti were, before the war, they made scaffold poles. So that's why it's very tubular and very like it is, really.
The reason we're here is museums have always been rich hunting grounds for me. And what I'd really like is the fact that a lot of these look unrestored, you know, untouched, and that's where it's at for me. These really interest me. So tell me about this one. I've never seen a pickup truck.
This is an FD. It's 150cc again.
Rare?
Yes, quite rare, yeah. Very expensive. For this one, for instance, would cost between $8,000 and $9,000.
One scooter in particular has caught Drew's eye.
As we walked in, I like the look of this.
Yeah.
So tell me about this. What year is this? Is this 50s?
Yeah, it's a Series 2 LD. It's 1956.
Yeah.
It's mostly original. It's been hand-painted, but it's not too bad.
I like that.
And the little mirror, yeah.
I like that a lot.
Lambretta's LD model scooters were first launched in 1951 and were part of their more luxurious range. They came with pillion seats as standard and reached a top speed of 50 miles per hour. This bike could be worth around £2,500.
I would sell it for £2,000.
Tempting, isn't it? I just like the shape and I like the originality. So can I make you an offer on it? It's open to offers because I've got to get a deal.
Of course, I'm open to offers.
It's in my nature, I can't help it. I've got a figure in mind, I don't know if you'll accept it, but £1,500. Take it away.
I really can't accept that. I bought it for that amount of money. I've spent another £100 on it, and I've got to make a little bit of profit on it as well.
18?
1850.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, love it. Marvellous. No Thank you very much. There you go. Bought Lambretta.
Ride it home.
You are. We can go out for a little Sunday rise on this tea. I think this is quite a small investment that might have a small return. But I don't think I'm going to lose money. But if somebody comes and offers me £100 profit on it tomorrow, they can have it. You've got to be able to let things go.
With a star purchase of a vintage Lambretta in the bag, the next stop is upstairs to search through the scootering memorabilia.
So what have you got in here? Just stuff and...
This is mainly a storage room.
OK.
It's got a lot of memorabilia in.
Oh, there's a picture of you on the back there.
It's an old clock.
Vespa Club de France.
Vespa clubs began in the 1950s as enthusiasts held rallies all across Europe. This late 1950s clock is by one of France's oldest clockmakers, Laporte. As a piece of scootering memorabilia and in full working condition, it could be worth around £300.
It's got on it Vespa Club of France. The clock itself would be interesting without that. That just gives it another dimension. So, yeah, definitely something I want to buy. What do you want for it?
Make me an offer and let's see.
I will kick off, 100 quid. Sold, fantastic. I thought we had to start that. That's great. That's great.
Well, do you want a bar? No.
That's fine. Yeah, £100 for the clock. Bit of a steal, actually. That's of interest as well. Is it an original one?
I think it is. Yeah, it looks like it's been well used. Yeah. Somewhere.
Dell'Orto is an Italian company which has been making carburettors since the 1930s. Original metal advertising signs like this are desirable to collectors and could be worth around £120.
Dell'Orto carburettors were used on Vespas and on Lambrettas, but also they were used on lots and lots of really fast sports cars as well. So anybody who's got Dell'Ortos on their car will want that sign. What do you want for that?
£20.
Sold. Fantastic. Thank you very much. Lovely. The sign was 20 quid, so a bargain. You know, if I sold it for 60 quid, it'd still be cheap, wouldn't it? But I think it's worth a bit more than that as well.